قال النعمة عن الخير. That he want to see this favor from Allah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon his servant. This servant, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this. But the one that has envy in his heart, he want to see that removed from that individual. Not that he just necessarily want to have it, but he doesn't want him to have it. He say, إِذَا رَأَى عَلَىٰ أَحَدْ نِعْمَةً فَإِنَّهُ يَتَغَاضَ. He say, if the person he see a type of favor from Allah in this individual, he become furious. He become very furious. وَيَتَمَنَّى زَوَالِ هَذِهِ النِّعْمَةِ حَسَدًا وَبَغْيًا. And he want to see this favor from Allah to be removed from the servant. And he want it to be removed. And he say, حَسَدًا, as envious, being envious. He say, وَبَغْيًا, and as transgression. He want to see that to be removed from that servant. The Shaykh Salaf Fawzan Hafidhullah, he say, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And we are seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this, in protection from Allah. And he say, وَهُوَ مِنْ أَعْذَمِ الْخِصَالِ الْمَذْمُومَةِ. He say, envy, it is one of the worst characteristics that the person can have. It is one of the worst description that a person can be described with. So therefore, now how do we fight ourselves from not having this type of attitude towards one another? One of the first thing, as the ulama mentioned, is that to be making dua secret to one another. Something that you see in your brother, that really, alhamdulillah, you see it, that you make dua secretly, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase him in that. Put barakah in him in that. This is barakallah, how we're going to remove this hasad in us. I mean, we're human beings, huh? We're human beings. Right? We're human beings. These are the things that we were barakallah created with. That we have to what? Fight our nafs to take away from this despicable khisalat, this despicable characteristics or description. So he mentioned, لِأَنَّ فِيهِ إِعْرَاضًا عَلَى اللَّهِ. Because when a person having hasad, he is having objection against Allah. This is like Allah, he decreed that it was going to be on him. Right? So it is as if you're saying, Allah, you haven't done what is right. Because this individual does not deserve this, or this individual shouldn't have it. It's not for him to have it. So he mentioned, so it is i'radan ala Allah. It is to have an objection against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa fihi isa'ah ila al-khalq. It is of an evil character with the people. So the one that have hasad, al-hasid, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is having objection on what Allah has decreed. And he is having a bad mannerism with the people. That's why a person that have this hasad in him, he cannot cooperate. He cannot mingle with the people. Because he cannot sit well with him to see right from the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in other servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُدْخُلُ فِيهِ الْعَائِنِ. So the person can have this barakallah in his heart. He having hasad, you know, having like this. I wish this guy want to have this. Not because he want it, but he just don't want to see him have it. So also in it, when we say وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَد, شَصَالَ فَوْضَ حَفِظَهُ اللَّهِ say وَيَدْخُلُ فِيهِ, and also it enters in it العائن. العائن بارك الله فيكم, it mean the one that has the evil eye. The one that has the evil eye. And another issue that is important for all of us to understand this. It is not that when we read the likes of this, we will not, a person look at you twice, you're going to think about the evil eye. Some people sometimes they blame the evil eye. But wallahi, they are their own evil eye. They are their own evil eye. Or they have something now, they lost it. They have a car, it broke down or whatever the case might be. And they think about, okay, you know, I think I've been afflicted by the evil eye. How do you know? Okay, this is a matter of the unseen. But you should have looked at your own self first. Look at yourself. هل أنت مطيع إلى الله? Are you obedient to Allah? أم عاصٍ على الله? Or are you someone that is in opposition of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded? If you are in opposition of what Allah commanded, you are your own evil eye. You are your own, you know, destructor. وَالْعِيَّاذُ بِاللَّهِ. But we affirm that the evil eye exists. We affirm this. We affirm this because this is what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned this. And as inshallah we're gonna mention about that which had happened from the individual, from the Sahaba that Midhal was afflicted by evil eye. Inshallah sanati bidhalik bi'idhnillah. So he say, وَيُدْخِلُ فِيهِ الْعَائِنِ, and that which is the one that had the evil eye also enter into, when we say, مِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. He say, الَّذِي يُصِيب بِنَظَرَتِهِ, for the one that he will inflict with his evil eye. Meaning by way of his evil eye, he will, barakallah, also cause harm. By also his evil eye, he will cause harm. But the evil eye, barakallah fikum, know that it is of two types. The one that is in the individual. Tayyib. Meaning it is not something that he is, and he will do it purposely. Right? And the other one is that those, they have it purposely. They have this envy in it and they will put all their senses to it. But I'm not the one that doesn't have it, meaning it's something that is in him. Abtalahu Allah bidhalik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with that. طيب. So he mentioned here, he said, لِأَنَّ إِصَابَتِي بِالْعَيْنِ نَوْعٌ مِنَ الْحَسَدِ. Because striking the evil eye, طيب, it is one of the types of hasad, envy. Right? Striking, right? Or being, now I'm striking with the evil eye, is one of the type of envy. So we can say envy, it is, barakallahu fikum, that which the individual, he can have in his heart, or with that which he can do with his eyes. Huh? Right, stricken it with the eye, meaning the individual, barakallah, he has this evil eye, and he, you know, struck the individual on with it until that person, barakallah fikum, was harmed. Allah yabarak fik. So he says, فَأَنْتَ تَسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ شُرُورٍ. So you are seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all of this evil that we have mentioned. The evil of the darknesses and that which is beneath in it, meaning the wild animals, right? And the beast, the wild beast, and that which, barakallahu fikum, we don't see during the night. And likewise, barakallahu fikum, from the what he called, barakallahu fikum, min sharri naffathati fil uqad, those who are the magicians and the likes of them. And likewise, al-hasid, the one that is the envier. So when we recite, barakallahu fikum, these verses, that we are seeking refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all of this evil, from all of this harm, from all of this harm and all of this evil. He say, فَدَلَّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْإِسْتِعَاذَ عِبَادَةِ لَا يَجُوزُ. He say, أَن تُصَرِّفْ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ. He say that this is a proof that seeking refuge is an act of worship, that it is not permissible to be seeking refuge in anyone except in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, فَلَا تَسْتَعِذْ بِالْمَخْلُوقِ. So therefore, do not seek refuge, in a creator, or in a creation, ma'adhira. Do not seek refuge in a creation. He says, so therefore, وَمَنْ إِسْتَعَاذَ بِمَخْلُوقٍ فَقَدْ أَشْرَكَ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Whoever seek refuge in a creation, then he has indeed a ascribed partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever sought refuge in other than in Allah, he has indeed, barakallahu al-jami', has ascribed a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqulu li Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told to Ibn Abbas. What was Ibn Abbas' name? Muhammad. What was Ibn Abbas' name? You forgot. Abu Zura. Abu Musa. What was the name of Ibn Abbas? Abdullah. Ahsanta. Abdullah. Abdullah Ibn Abbas. For next week homework, the kunya of Ibn Abbas. The kunya of Ibn Abbas. Right? The kunya, like Abu Zura, Abu Musa, Abu Fatima, Abu Aisha, Abu Ismail, Abu Asma. Huh?
Abu Bakr.
Abu Man.
I'm just giving the kunya.
Right, these are this what I'm just giving the reference are the kunya. Tayyib. Farid, what's your kunya? Farid, what's your kunya?
Abu Abdul Malik.
Abu Abdul Malik. Barakallah. Fi. Alhamdulillah, from the sunnah is that we implement this, calling the people by the kunya. Abdullah, what's your kunya? Abu? Usman. Abu Uthman. Tayyib. So we call the brothers like this, barakallah. Fi. And it has, alhamdulillah, it developed a type of love when you hear the brother call you by your son or by your daughter. Or by your kunya. Yeah, that means a sunnah, barakallah fi. Right? Talha. Huh? Yeah.
Did you give us a hint?
In what? No, I don't give hints.
No, I'm saying, was that a hint?
Was that? The kunya? Yeah, I was just giving a, yeah, I was just showing, yes. Yes, taba'an, yes, taba'an. Jazakallah khairan, shaykhana. So the kunya of Ibn Abbas. What is the kunya of Ibn Abbas by next week, inshallah? And then, alhamdulillah, we call the brothers by the kunya, Abu Munira, you know, Abu Shu'aib, right? We call the people by the kunya. And this, alhamdulillah, هذا يدخل في قلب المسلم سرورا. It enters some type of happiness in the person's heart. You call the brother by his name and you call him by his kunya, it's different. Huh? It's very much different. So, alhamdulillah, we established that sunnah of calling alhamdulillah in our kunya in by our kunya inshallah ta'ala. If you don't know the brother's kunya, ask him his kunya inshallah. Allah yahfadhukum jami'an. So Sheikh Saleh al-Fawdan hafidhahullah, he say, so therefore, and he say, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, he say, إِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. إِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you're seeking aid and assistance, only seek it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, if you're seeking rescue, if you're seeking refuge, only seek it from in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. And likewise, in the statement of Allah, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس من الجنة. Some people they will say من الجنة من الجنة. قال الله تعالى, what can be translated to mean say, meaning O Muhammad, I seek refuge in Allah, in the Lord of the mankind, the king of mankind. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ, who is the rightfully to be worshipped, and who is the only one deserving to be worshipped by mankind. مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ, from the evil of the whisperer, from the evil of the whisperer. مِنْ شَرِّ وسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس, the one that whisper and then withdraw. He whisper and then he withdraw. This is a very important point. Barakallahu fi. Sheikh Fawdan will explain this. He said, the one who whisper into the heart of mankind from the jinn and from men. شَسَالَفَ وَذَنْ حَفِظَهُ اللَّهِ سَيْ أَمَرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِالْإِسْتِعَاذَةِ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. Here in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mighty and majestic, He commanded us.